Welcome to two examples involving the addition property of definite integrals. To help illustrate these examples, we'll assume f of x is this function here graphed in red, which is a non-negative function. We're given the definite integral of f of x from 1 to 6 equals the definite integral of f of x from 1 to 4 plus the definite integral of f of x from a to b, and we're asked to find a and b. Because f of x is non-negative, if we integrate f of x from 1 to 6, it would give us the area of this blue shaded region, which means the sum of these two definite integrals must also give us the same area. So looking at the right side of this equation, we have the integral of f of x from 1 to 4. Well, if we integrate this function on the interval from 1 to 4, it would give us this area here. And therefore, to get the total area, this second integral here must be integrated on the interval from 4 to 6, giving us the remaining area, or this area here. And that means a must be equal to 4, and b must be equal to 6. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have the integral of f of x from 1 to 3 must equal the definite integral of f of x from 1 to 5 plus the definite integral of f of x from a to b. And once again, we want to find the value of a and b. So notice in this case, on the left side, if we integrate from 1 to 3, we would get this area here in blue. So we want the sum of these two integrals to be equal to this blue area. But notice this first definite integral from 1 to 5 would give us more area than we have here in blue. It would actually give us all of this area here. Which means you now want to subtract out this area here. But notice how we don't have a subtraction sign here, we have an addition sign. So if we want to subtract out this area here, instead of integrating from 3 to 5, we can change the order of integration and integrate from 5 to 3. If we integrate f of x from 5 to 3, it would return a negative value, or we can think of it as subtracting out this area here, which means a would be equal to 5 and b would be equal to 3. That's going to do it for these two examples. In the next example, we'll take a look at a problem where we have a subtraction of two definite integrals.